The main attraction.
You are the main attraction of Headspace.
You are the main attraction of Headspace. On that note, welcome to Headspace, everybody.
What's up, what's up, what's up?
Welcome, guys.
So it's your boy, JSR.
It's your boy, Chris Chrome.
And it is Dr. Damon. We are your lovely host for this number 21, guys.
That's 21 right. Straight weeks in
that's
a
like
row.
It's like getting a blackjack. Just putting it out there.
So, how'd you guys fare last week for without me? Did you guys make a pillowcase and put one of my shirts?
We strive for the golden medal.
We did what we could.
And you know, it's just not the same.
The internet treated us like they did the last time we were together.
Oh no!
We realized that without you, we are not cool or popular to this internet.
Okay, we get it, internet folk. We get it. Okay.
Okay. Well, just make sure to have a girl every time.
Well, I'll give you a cutout of my face so you can pluck it on a pillow next time.
All right.
Fine. I'm down with that.
Let's get into some real shit. When I say real shit, I mean, let's talk about our soda streams, everybody.
Oh, look at that, bringing it right back like again.
I have some Tim Hortons, but we are going to get that sponsorship one day. And today I'm rocking the root beer. Just had to go proper with it.
I got the old-fashioned lemonade because I like to be old-fashioned.
And I'm drinking that classic cola, you know, keeping up with the sugar.
All right.
Soda stream. Please sponsor us.
Absolutely. So today, what are we talking about? What's our big topic?
So basically, we're going to talk about online frauds, scams, and we're also going to review Raekwon's Wild.
Absolutely. So for the sake of keeping your interest, if at any point you get bored and go, are they going to talk about anything else? Hit the show more in the comments below. All the topics, all the songs, everything's listed, and you can just click to exactly where you want to go. And that way you can skip over shit you may not care about. On that note, who's ready to talk about some fraud?
Well, we are.
So, guys, here's what's happening in our headspace today.
What is happening?
Online frauds. Like, honestly, I get 12 emails a day, like, asking me, like, oh, why did you have to cancel? Give us a feedback. And it's from SurveyMonkey, and the email is at feedback@feedback.com, and there is absolutely no mention of what I have canceled.
Well, clearly they just want your feedback, though.
Yeah, but, like, when you click on it, it's a link to, like, enter your name, your date of birth, your postal code, your information,
look at these cheeky
and then
people.
These are all, like...
And then if she clicks on it, I get an email from Damon saying, hey, check out this SurveyMonkey thing.
Mm-hmm.
You should click on that link.
Look at that, using the joys of automatic sending.
No, but that was like, you remember the time when we used to fucking send emails and like,
chain
just
letters?
Like, I'm so, no, but not, the, yeah, those two, but just like, I'm so sorry, guys, don't get the emails, blah, blah, blah. Like,
man, my Skype got hacked actually recently. And it got sent out and everything. Yeah, it just happens.
Mm-hmm.
You get it every now and again. Somebody, you change your password. Okay, fine. Life moves on, but that's a phishing scam, is I believe the term for it, where the whole point is to click and they capture your information and boom, they have access to your emails and.
Yeah.
Possibly other terrible shit.
Yeah.
And then if they get that password and you're like any of the other people online who don't have lots of passwords, bad news bears, everybody.
We at Headspace care about your security, guys. That's why we talk about these topics. Let us know if you want to know more, definitely. So let's talk about, like, have you guys ever been, like, frauded? Like, any approaches to you guys?
My bank account got frauded once, and then the money got taken, and I had to go through that process of waiting 3 weeks for them to unlock your funds again, and I got my money back, so I guess all's well that ends well.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody, like, I've had my cards compromised, things like that, but I can't say I've ever really fallen prey to one of these fraud-like scams, as we were going to talk about, but I know people who have.
Well, actually, I'm on the same boat as Holden. I've never really fallen victim or prey to any of these scams, but I do know some stories and some people who may have committed and or not have been experienced to it.
I've spent hours on the internet watching stories related to this type of stuff over the last few years, so.
Mm-hmm. No,
it's a growing thing. It's a growing thing, and it's happening very frequently all over everywhere. I mean, fuck, your credit cards aren't safe. Your information ain't safe. The internet's not a safe place, people. It's not a safe place.
No, but it continuously comes back to, like, research before you do anything, guys.
Right.
Make sure that the HTTPS is present in the page, and as well as any, like, verified, any credit card verified place is going to get an SQL logo at the bottom.
Which is
so
true.
You can take
now,
a look at that.
The problem is, when it comes down to, let's say, like, we were going to start off with the medicines. Let's say we're going to go buy some fake medicine online.
Mm-hmm.
A really good company is going to have some kind of an S, or maybe they don't have the S, but they'll have a fake SQL thing or whatever the secure logo is. They'll have a fake Norton verified thing, and you actually have to click on these little buttons to have the page open and actually authenticate it, because if you just see it, it's actually not enough. They're clickable shits. They're like actual certificates that are put there. So there are ways to verify the mm-hmm. legitimacy of a page. But what's more scary is how people are manipulated into getting into fraudulent product pages where they're buying shit. Like, you were telling us about the fake medicine pop-ups, like the alternative generics to, like, name brands,
yeah,
if you
want
to go into that a bit.
Yeah, so basically, like, online pharmacies is a type of fraud, like, where basically it was very popular, let's say, in the U.S., where you actually have to pay for your medicine, you have to pay for your treatments, and sometimes that means thousands of dollars. Like, we don't understand. Here
we're
in Canada.
We don't have to really pay. Unless,
unfortunately, like, to a certain extent, though, we have
stuff you have to pay, but let's say you had to go to the hospital and you got prescribed some crazy-ass medicine that might have cost an American $1,000. It's only going to cost us, like, $80.
Yeah, or, like, even though we have work insurance also that covers, like, up to... Anyways, so in these cases, like, people would get clickbait into, like, these ads on the site. It's like medicine prescription online doctors, and you go on these websites and you click on it and they magically know the prescription you need for the illness you described, and then after that, you know, you send them pictures and like, does this look like herpes?
But none
and, like,
of us ever remember actually doing this.
No,
shit.
But it's not. It's, but you'd be surprised at how much, you know what, these cyber online frauds.
Okay,
here's
an example. No, but just how easy it is to fall for it, even if you know better. You might go to a site that's not even related to this pharmacy site, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, check if my email address has been breached. Hit enter. I did that like
eight. That sounds familiar.
I actually did that about 2 months ago, and I was like, oh, fuck. Had to go change the password and shit because I just, mm-hmm. you know. But even still, I added my email address to a list, which creates me as a data point. And then this pharmacy guy buys the list, but then there's other data attached to my email, so he knows, oh, maybe Holden likes this
kind
of stuff.
So they just keep passing it on and passing
it
on.
No, but it could be anything. It could be like for hair dyeing, like you want your hair a certain color, or if Holden has been searching on the internet, like how to avoid like calvicie or whatever.
What hair gel works best to make long hair stand straight?
Like,
these are big
questions. A lot of things you click on, right, on your computer, you do search. Haven't you noticed your Facebook is sort of littered with it on the side?
Yeah.
It's all like things.
Marketing, baby.
So in these cases, basically, they get, like, advertised medicine at a lower cost, so that's where they would save in these circumstances. So they always click on it, they get their information, and then they get sent either expired medicine, you're talking about medicine that is not
or
medicine.
Or just fucking fake medicine.
Or just, like, placebos, or just, like, the wrong medicine,
or
even poison.
Worse. That's like, it.
Just,
like, stuff that's not quality controlled,
mm-hmm.
or... Sure, 80% of the batches might even do what's right, but then that guy has a heart attack. And so it's just shit that skirts the authorities. But where it becomes fraudulent is how it's presented to people,
mm-hmm.
right? So it's not like presented. Like, look at Dr. Oz. That's some fucking scammy-ass fraudulent bullshit there. You guys can go check out the fraud case that happened with him recently. So he goes on and he promotes diet pills, like these magical bullshit.
There we go.
Even though they fucking don't work and there's no real science, but he calls them magic pills that do. And the way they present it, it's like all these poor fools go out there and buy it, trying to lose weight with these magic diet pills, even though they're actually hurting themselves. And it's endorsed by celebrities.
There's the anti-aging too industry that gets into that a lot, or like the man enhancing
it's
when you see Ron Jeremy on an ad, remember,
most
he was
like
born
physical
with it.
Attributes. There's a
lot
of targeting towards insecurities, too.
Because what's the issue with people? Like, society is like,
you're too fat, you're too this.
No, but
you don't
now we're going
much,
somewhere
you...
different. This is more like, it's not about insecurities. This is like...
But they'll be targeted.
No, but this is more like they know because you have pneumonia that you need this type of medicine, so they're offering you the generic version of that type of medicine. This is more playing in a more direct sense on, like, the medicines you
mm-hmm.
need based on their data. Whereas what we're talking about with the insecurities is a bit like the pharmaceutical industry trying to get people to get drugs.
We're not talking about those pharmaceuticals. We're talking about those fake programs that are just there to bait you into getting
mm-hmm.
those things,
I would say that they're often based off the fact that you actually needed those things in the first place. So it's not, I don't know, it's more, here's an economic.
So is it more marketing?
It's absolutely about money, right? All of this shit is not about, it's about the guys who are selling you shit are doing what they can to sell you anything to make money. So they get bad shit, they brand it as magic shit, and they sell it to you. And you're buying it because you're like, I need cancer curing pills, so I can't afford that. And now you're going to go buy what they say is cancer curing pills. So it's false advertising. It's like fucking just badness. It's,
yeah, just go to the pharmacy, guys.
I don't know.
Just or go ask your doctor.
Their
like
whole healthcare
to...
situation down in the States just got a lot more
complicated.
Yeah.
Fuck!
So I don't know how easy it is for any of our American viewers to actually go do that. Hashtag, I'm sorry you guys got trumped.
I'm sorry.
But yeah, no, I think that it even transcends medicines and enlarge. It's just any kind of like, I don't know. I'm sure there's therapy that gets sold. Mm-hmm. There's all sorts of.
Well, there's a lot of things that get like sold or advertised and that are marketed as certain like therapy, medicine, like food tags. I've seen scams for like food stamps.
Yeah, there are
and
scams
shit like
for
that.
Like tickets
it's,
and stuff
it's,
like that.
They
a lot of shit.
They're targeting. I feel like there's specific targets when you go after that.
Of
granted,
course.
Some of it feels like marketing a little bit. Or like,
well,
even when they get analyzed,
these
or
scams are based off of marketing, man. So when you set up a scam like this, you look for what's an industry I can go play in where there's lots of people who have money that will give it to me. And I think it's actually worth at this point talking a bit about a great example. That's those Nigerian scams and those ridiculously over the top. Prince Alibaba over here, he's in jail and he's a mad fucking millionaire. And if you send him $300 right now, when he gets to safety over in friggin' Turkey or something, he gonna hook you up with 7 million Great British Pounds or some shit like that. It'll only cost you this now. You gotta pay him right away.
Whew. Yep.
And there's a million versions of that shit. Anything that sounds ludicrous, that some fucking you won the lottery.
If it
you
walks like a duck and it quacks like a duck, it's,
then it's
probably
a
duck. Damon, you fucked it up.
Wait. Why? Because this is like if it walks and talks like a duck and
it's probably
it is
a
duck,
mouse.
And it were a duck, that would mean I'd get the $47 billion.
Right. But I'm saying like if it seems ludicrous and it is ludicrous, then it's probably very ludicrous. Like it's probably
I'm
just
put it
ridiculously.
Out there, I'm with Damon on the expression and how it should go. Boom. Just saying, but no. It's fucked up shit.
Let the doctor take you back to nursery school.
It's okay. Take me back, please.
Yeah, you guys you should peruse the internet, man. On YouTube, there's hundreds of videos of people fucking with these Nigerian scammers, and they can go into a lot of detail onto what happens if you pay, and what happens if you follow through with them, and what happens if you email them. There's some interesting ones I've seen. I don't know if
you... It's a broad subject, but guys, I'm bringing you information that I got from Planet Dohan. Dolan, sorry. P-D-O-L. I'll put the link in. So
we'll
these are... Go check it out. That's where I'm getting my information anyways. It's pretty...
I'm getting mine from like 3 years worth of being curious on the subject and maybe knowing stuff I'm not supposed to know on the subject.
Oh, and just at work too. I live to it every day to day. That's all I get. Fraud after fraud after fraud. And it's easy to spot, but...
Gotta love work.
I want to switch it.
I'm not going to talk about my work on this podcast.
No, it's okay. Let's switch it to, let's say Craigslist.
Okay, that still falls under the same kind of, like, because that's a more localized version of this ludicrous Nigerian scam, right?
Right.
So we can talk about your elaborate one. I know that story you were telling us.
Yeah, so let's take a look at some potential frauds. Like, okay.
On Craigslist.
You're looking for an apartment. No you comment. Absolutely want it. It's
I do.
Super
I do.
Important.
Whatever. So you're
you
gotta looking.
Gotta live somewhere.
Yeah. So you go, you heard about Craigslist, you've been on there, you had
that's
a little
good
hookups. Place. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Look into the list and like, let me see if I can get an apartment. So I get into the apartment searches like, oh my God, there's a 5.5. Wow.
Ooh,
okay. How much is it?
That's 3 bedrooms, folks.
Yeah, for us anyways. And a bathroom. The half is the bathroom.
And a kitchen and a living room.
But
and does it come with a balcony?
It does. Oh. And the view, the view, it's amazing.
Oh, look how juicy this all sounds. Where's the catch?
It's on the property of the White House.
Oh, wait a minute. Really?
I get
really
to live near Trump? This is super exciting.
This is awesome.
You can You can literally Trump at him from your balcony and be okay with it. Anyways.
Right, tell me more. I'm hooked.
So, and $600, and it's really cool, guys, right?
What?
That's wait, a great You know what? Shut up and take my money. Sold. I want it.
Can I have your money, please? Here.
Yeah, exactly. That's not money. So first and last payment.
I bought it.
Basically, $1,200 you just gave him. Right?
Yeah, $1,200. I want it. I want to live next to Trump.
How do you give him the money?
Oh, you enter your information. Like you pay him through credit card information.
Oh, wire fraud. It's probably.
Okay, hold on.
Ooh,
so let me go get my laptop.
This is probably Western Union or more wire transfers.
Oh,
yeah.
Something like that. You got to transfer money, anyways. And then after that, you got the apartment.
But where's the apartment, Damon? Tell us.
On the property of the White House.
But can I have the keys?
Yeah, sure. Just show up. They know who you are.
All right, cool.
And then you go to the White House and...
So, guys, I went to go check out my apartment, and they won't let me on through the gates.
Okay.
404
so let's say
not found.
Okay, so that's a clearly ludicrous example of what can happen on Craigslist. But let's go like more realistic and how it can hit closer to home. Let's talk about looking for apartments, because we're not done with this, Chris. Jeez, man.
Oh, yeah.
So let's say you're going... In my local city of Montreal, there's this fun habit that's not legal that every landlord in the city does, called asking for deposits.
Ooh-hoo.
So
yes.
That would mean you show up and you see it. Now, whereas in a lot of places you pay first and last month's rent, that's not the case here. When you sign a lease, they can ask for first month's rent, that's it. But instead they go, give us $50 for a key deposit or whatever other bullshit.
They're not allowed to do
that. Not allowed. They're going to do it. I recommend doing it if you like the place. Fuck it. Well, I've done it in every place I've ever taken, so fuck it. If I want the place, I'll play ball. But let's say you're on Craigslist and you find some shady ass person and they come in and the whole place is nice and furnished. They're like, yeah, it's a sublet, blah, blah, blah. And you're like, okay, this is cool. I really want to live here. And you're as eager as Chris was to hand money over. So Chris hands over his $50 deposit. Don't worry, I'm back on the first. You leave, you call back, no answer. No answer. But it was all in cash, right? Because, you know, it's $50. The
come
fuck?
On. It was
there's
a
no
legal
anything.
Transaction.
No, there's no record of your transaction. So it just never happened.
Fuck me.
And you don't have any proof of it and et cetera. And then this is more of like a localized version of the fraud. And anything can happen online. I've sold and bought shit on Craigslist. I don't want to talk like it's just a place of scams. In fact, 95% of my experiences on Craigslist have been excellent due to, you know, scrutiny and not being stupid with it. But there is a lot of fraud and there is a lot of fake shit, and you do need to apply a certain level of discretion online. And here's my general rule of thumb. If it's too good to be true, it probably is not true. Not some weird shit like if it talks like a duck and it walks like a duck, then it's a duck. Because that's weird. But if it's too good to be true, fuck that idea. Go find the hard, long way. It's probably smarter.
All right, I'll accept that.
Okay.
At least on Craigslist or unregulated places where if something goes bad, fuck you. It's a buyer's risk, right?
Chris, okay, here's another one that's actually more ludicrous, if you want me to use the word.
All right, I'm ready. Let's go.
Okay, so it's called... Okay, I'm not going to say it now. Let me tell you the story.
Okay.
Let me
I
tell
like
you
stories.
A story, kids. Story time. Dr. Damon time. All right, so basically, my sister... I'm just kidding. Okay, so my sister really, really wanted a dog. She really wanted one, and then she hops on Craigslist and like, oh my god, this one's so cute, it's so perfect, and it's from a girl's name. Like, the girl's name is pretty Quebecer, right? So we're from Quebec, so it was pretty something familiar, something close from home. So we're like, her address is there, it's in Montreal. So she's like, okay, cool, like, the dog, she contacts the girl, and she's like, hey, yeah, I'm traveling with the dog, I'm in Europe. So I'm going to have to send the dog to you. I'm not going to charge you for the dog. Like, it's a prize-winning breed, so it's a very expensive dog. All you'll need to take care of is the plane ticket. How much is that? It's $800. $800. I'm like, I look at my sister, and I'm like, Jade, this doesn't
sound right.
Hold on.
If it looks like a dog like a dog, then
hold
it must
on.
Be a duck.
I need to repeat because I can't say her name.
That's okay. Duck.
I look at my sister. And she'll understand that too. I look at my sister and I tell her, like, this doesn't smell right. Like, this is just too weird. Like, I wouldn't do that. Like, go to the pet store and get one that's equally cute and equally fluffy and you'll be happy. And she was like, no, no, I could trust this girl. I've talked to her by email. Sure. She's nice. Hold on. This isn't the cat. She's like, I'm going for it. I'm like, okay, you know what? It's your money, but fuck, don't fuck yourself with it. But anyways. Yeah, yeah. And then she's like, okay, she calls the girl and, yeah, she calls the girl and then she's like, and I'm like, I'm like, hold on, stop. Hang up the call. And she's like, okay. And she shows me the number and it's an African number.
Oh, Africa.
So, close from home, she's in Europe. You just have to pay for the plane ticket. You call her, she's actually from Africa. Me, my mom, my brother, we were like, okay, nope, we're going to take you to the pet store. So, yeah, so that's what happened to that. So these are called, this is actually a scam. It's a pet delivery scam type of thing.
Whew. Why are you fucking with animals?
Because it's close from home. There's a market for everything. You gotta keep in mind,
there's no dog here, Chris. You're just fucking with animal lovers.
Yes. Yeah.
You know, it's more criminal.
It's like that fucking in the arms of the angel. Like the fucking,
yeah, I know what you're talking about. That's with the starving children in Africa.
With the, yeah, or like the puppy mills and like every day.
That's a whole other conversation.
Yeah, yeah, it is.
But you wanted to talk about money laundering and other types of shit.
Oh, yeah. But you go.
Money laundering? Well, the only thing I can think of for this type of frauds and scams, and maybe it's a little more of a theory than I have fact-based, but okay. My city's full of condos. Mm-hmm. And the mayor of my city, the one that used to be the mayor, recently got into jail for fraud in terms of construction deals and other such things, right?
Okay.
And condos just keep appearing everywhere in our city. They just keep appearing in places.
Gentrification.
It's not even just gentrification. I am a firm believer that a lot of these construction companies are just money laundering schemes that are pushing building and construction contracts through, regardless of whether or not they're worth being done, simply because construction is just one of those industries. Or we can look at our super hospital. I don't know, a giant 20-year scammy, fraudy money just moved through it like candy, hired an $8 million art director for no reason. It was fucked up, man.
Yeah, it was weird.
So on a criminal front, there's all sorts of things that just happen fraudulently that impact us.
Okay, how about this? Let me boggle your minds a little bit.
You can boggle.
I need to send you an email.
Okay.
Open up the email. Hello, sir. So what we're offering is a placeholding type of thing. So what we need from you is to be able to put money in your account. You have access to 90% of it. And a 10% fee would apply at that point. So basically, like, yeah, that sounds like a great deal, right? Right?
Yep.
Sounds like an awesome deal. So here's my bank information. Perfect. Now, we got this through. You get the money in the account. You're like, awesome. But it's not just small amounts of money. Ones. It's like huge deposits of money. And then guess big what? Guess.
I don't think it's mine.
No, here's what happens.
Like, I just don't
that
think it's mine.
That money's not clean because you're basically holding the temporary money that's being laundered through that construction shit I was talking about before.
Knock. Open the door. CIA, sir, your account has been flagged. And you're like, shit. It's like,
you're liable too, right?
Yeah, you are because you provided the authorization.
In the words of like Office Space, we're not talking about minimum security. We're talking about maximum take it up the ass type security prison if you get caught on this shit.
Yep.
So basically people approach you. I actually had this happen to me once. I took a job interview thing, right? I talked to the guy on the phone and he explained it like this. Look, you sign some papers, you basically open up a company in your name, we take care of everything for you, we just put money in and then you get a percentage of whatever happens with this money, blah blah blah, you know, you become blah blah blah, and so you're basically a scapegoat in case something goes bad. Mm-hmm. And there's layers and layers, but it and this is where you're preying up on people who are broke, who need jobs, usually ignorant folk. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of presented in this get rich quick kind of philosophy.
Yeah.
And it's messed up, man. It's just, it's Ooh, crazy.
You want messed up?
I like messed up. Do you like messed up, Chris?
I enjoy messed up. I've seen some really fucked up, messed up fraud videos today, but go on.
Okay. Seriously, get another email.
Oh, man.
He's like, Hello, Chris. Oh, no, hold on. Dearly loved.
Oh, Chris.
Dearly loved.
Here, finally.
I am speaking on behalf of our dearly departed, blah, 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 who was your second time removed, put aside, and then locked in the closet for many years, uncle. And he was, I have the great pleasure to tell you that he instructed in your will to give you his $50 billion industry.
I've never even met this man.
Chris,
I know.
He owns Intel. How did you not know him?
Met this man.
But he feels guilty for not having taken the time to, like, spend time with you.
He
and
feels
he...
so guilty. I acquire time and patience better than
but
money.
Chris, you need
the
to give us your bank account information.
I don't know. Why? I don't...
Hold on. The only thing we ask is that you pay a small fee to help the family of the departed.
My family?
Yes.
So
the,
wait.
The ones closest.
Hold on. Wait. So okay. So you're telling me there's people out there. If that's how this goes on this overly dramatic scene, you have to donate to the family that has lost. Wait,
yes,
but if he's my second, third removed uncle of my grandfather.
But
well,
some
Chris,
people
just
get
to be
excited.
Fair, you wouldn't necessarily know his immediate family.
Here's a prescription from Dr. Damon's little notepad here, guys. If it's more suspicious than a nun doing squats in a cucumber field, stay away from it.
Oh, I get it, guys.
Anyways.
Also fucked up.
Mm-hmm.
Is when people present all sorts of ways to capture your information. Because even
Ooh.
If they're not asking for your money, right?
Mm-hmm.
So let's say in a lot of these cases, they want your money.
Mm-hmm.
Your opinions, your information is worth money. So if you give them your email, your phone number, your name, all of this, and you give it to website one,
mm-hmm.
there's a huge fucking economy and lead list. So any of those telemarketing type bullshits where they call your house and go, hi, you're in debt, hi, this, hi, we
mm-hmm.
got it. Anyway, all of this.
Oh, your account is in security fraud
anything,
and blah, blah, blah. Please
however,
contact us.
However legal or illegal the operation may be,
mm-hmm.
how they get the information that they get your numbers, you come across this pop-up. Get a free consultation, blah, blah, blah. Just give us your phone number now. And
Ooh.
That company calls you. You say, fuck you, go away. But it's too late because the second you hit the submit button, you basically voluntarily hand it over
mm-hmm.
all
personal
of your information.
Whatever information they ask for.
Let's go into an even more primal state of it that people are not realizing, and it's really striking me and pissing me off.
What?
Okay.
Facebook.
Whoa.
Easy as fuck. Like, I'm not talking about hacking and being, oh my god, my account is hacked, okay? Let's take it very deeply. One of the friends you've just added, like, one of, because we, let's be real between you and me. You haven't met every fucker on your friends list. Fuck you.
Nope.
That is not true. Fuck off. Okay? Don't even try to tell me. Oh, they're getting that. Fuck. But, like, there's this one person that randomly pops up and is like, oh, my God, you know, we all come up from beautiful countries. Like, I was born in this city, this
yeah,
thing.
Yeah, yeah.
And
yeah,
everybody's
yeah.
like, oh, my God, like, blah, 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 this, blah, 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 that. Oh, I came from here and I came from that. And I saw this post and I was like, what the hell?
No,
I Okay, hold on.
It gets
and then
creepier
I,
than that. You
wanna... Oh, hold on. Let me just, like, I need to say, like, the point to this story. I'm sorry, like, I don't mean to interrupt you, but, like... Doesn't these questions sound like the security questions to your bank, like your bank account or your phone bill or like?
Absolutely.
Careful, colors, name of your first pet, fucking the city you were born, your mother's maiden name, like, yeah, stay away from
Why
it.
Why would anybody ask for your mother's maiden name unless...
It's like, hey, maybe we're from the same
no,
family tree. I heard that we're blessed
like, it's actually even like...
You know, there's
that,
a lot of shit
like
that.
Let's say that's kind of the more obvious side. You want to talk
mm-hmm.
about the less obvious side that mm. everyone's even guiltier of doing? Which Disney character are
oh!
you? Answer this easy 7 questions.
I've
oh,
done
look
it
at
a
these
few
questions.
Times.
Are you more like this? Are you more... So what you're doing now is you're creating character profiles. Now, you're giving all of this companies... access to your Facebook. You're saying I
or
permit you to scan all of this, right?
Yeah.
Now let's say the same company gets you to do it 37 times.
They have a little
they all
profile
have access
of you.
To the same you. And as a result of this type of information, we're now at a point where there's something called big data.
Clones are coming and taking over our lives.
No,
sorry.
But big data is kind of like where
that was a brain fart, by the way.
We're like, basically, they know so much about us that there's algorithms that, based off of like 100 Facebook likes, they can tell a whole bunch of you. Mm-hmm. So, like, if they can see 600 of your likes on Facebook, they can predict things about you that you don't know about yourself.
She's going to click on this next link that we've created specifically for them.
And as much as we can all say, we all collectively handed this information over. I don't know anybody who hasn't filled out 30 of those fuckers.
Like, no, I've done some. It's fun. It's entertaining. They make it alluring. That's what happens.
And the end result is marketing firms using that were used by Donald Trump in the last election. So we all contributed to that guy getting elected.
Fuck. Okay, so let's go into one that's a little bit darker. No, actually, you're going to take the lead on this one, I think. Nigerian frauds, like Nigerian scams.
Well, Nigerian scams is kind of encompassed in a lot of the same stuff that we've talked about. So it's the same premise of, the pet scam.
It's true.
Because it's all kind of the same thing. You'll notice that a lot of scams boil down to the same premise. Here's some really awesome opportunity that exists, right? Or here's some awesome thing. And even if it's down to information, here's what Disney character you're going to be.
Mm-hmm.
And there's no real sense to whatever.
There's no real connection to it.
And
really,
you go, hey, I want this or I want that information, whether it's get rich fast or whether it's get a cute puppy or whether it's help a Nigerian king get out of jail because he's locked up, or whether it's fucking gold. I don't know what it's going to be.
It could be anything. It ranges from different categories.
The words of Chris Crum, if it looks like a duck and if it walks like a duck, then it's probably a duck. We still don't know what that means, but Chris Crum says it, people.
Guys, the point is, like, cyber frauds and shit like this it's responsible for over $1 billion, every year.
Here's something you can do, though. Here's what you can do. A lot of these things are Googleable. If you come across a weird company, you can Google that weird company before you come across it.
Google is your best friend.
You know what? Even to that end, what you can do is look up suspicious things, right? There are little tricks to it. So if you understand how the internet marketing world works, there are things that are clean and safe and you'll come to understand. And then there's just little shady shit. So let's say you get PayPal's or SurveyMonkey's email like Damon had. Here's a quick tip to know whether or not it's legitimate. Where it says the name of the email address is, let's say, PayPal support, show details. Does it actually say support@paypal.com or no reply at PayPal? Or does it say xy7k4bb2@gy76? You know, like that gibberish bullshit that comes with all this fake stuff.
Does the top of the email include your first or your last name? Or both, actually?
No, actually, that doesn't. That's shit. They can fake it.
Usually, dear, blah, 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 blah. They'll give you your name.
But, like, so clean companies do that and dirty companies do that. I would say. Like, there's the internet marketing.
That's what I've been telling my customers.
The whole name thing is bad. It used to be that it can't have three dots in the subject line if it's fake, but it can. And there's so much shittery up there. So basically, if you get an email from MasterCard saying, here's a statement, and you don't trust it, call MasterCard and go. But call the real MasterCard. If you're getting fake phone number, anything. Basically, if you don't trust it, and if it sounds good and it looks like a duck, don't trust it because it's not a duck. Chris is wrong. And be suspicious of some shit. That's all I'm trying to say. I don't know what else to say on this fraud subject without going into it. I think we've covered a lot.
So let us know, guys. What do you think about what's happening in our headspace?
We're going to talk about fraud again. So let us know what parts of fraud you give a shit. Tell us your stories. Tell us what companies are fucking assholes.
Guys, I'm trying to vote in psychic frogs. Please, please. Look at the image.
Yeah, she wants to talk about psychics.
Vote me in.
And Chris just like, a life. Get a life.
I make a spiritual profit, so let's lock it in and begin.
Welcome back, guys. The break was good.
It was nice. So we're done talking about fraud and scams, and so now we're going to talk about a guy who used to do frauds and scams.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Well, I don't know specifically if he did frauds. Let's say he has a shady past, and that's a fair statement. He is a convicted felon. So we know that at some point or another, he has done bad things. He is a member of the Wu-Tang Clan. Mm-hmm. He is Raekwon himself.
Yeah, his name, Corey Woods, born in January 1970.
That makes him kind of old, is all I'm trying to say.
Yeah, but he's known as the pioneer of mafioso rap. He was converted to Muslim as well. What else do I know? Nothing. Nothing.
Wu-Tang. And Wu-Tang Clan ain't nothing to fuck with.
Oh, no, I actually, like, yeah, I like the Wu-Tang Clan. I like...
Chris, why don't you tell us what album we're talking about today?
Well, this week we decided to go with Raekwon's album. We decided to go with Raekwon's new album, The Wild.
Yes, that is the name of it. It came out March 24th, and so maybe we're a bit late. Fuck it. Raekwon, we tried to review you in February before the media duped us. So, Chris, or one of you two looked up that Raekwon did, in fact, do the right thing and tell the world, and the media ignored him.
Yep.
So we're on Team Raekwon. Just got to put it out there.
Yes.
Did you guys,
Hashtag Team Raekwon.
So, Chris, have you heard of Raekwon before this?
I've heard of him, never listened to him, and unfortunately never listened to Wu-Tang either. Not entirely true.
Oh, goodness gracious.
I've heard some of their songs, but, like, I never, like, dove into it. But I know them.
I've heard some of the Wu-Tang songs. I know of the Wu-Tang Clan. I did not know who they are. I did not know that Raekwon was one of them.
He is.
Yeah, I didn't. I'm sorry. I'm not good with band names.
He's one of the ones that had a solo career. So
that's a few of the
Wu-Tang guys didn't go very as far as some of the other ones. Raekwon's a top tier rapper, huge name in the industry. He's like one of those guys where if he appears on a song, you just kind of know it's going to be better, right? Like, and I never listened to a lot of his solo stuff, so this is definitely the first Raekwon album that I put on beginning to end, but I have listened to a lot of the Wu-Tang stuff before. I've seen him on features. He's not an unfamiliar person to me. I don't know. I don't have a lot to say about his context. I mean, over the course of, like, the Classic Quest, we're really going to delve into a lot of Wu-Tang talk. A lot of Raekwon albums are on our list.
I'm actually really excited for
that. So let's say, like, in fact, just to keep up with the spirit of it, a little bit of cross-promotion, but in a couple of weeks, we're going to talk about one of the classic Raekwon albums just to follow up this and go on from there. But
there's not only Headspace, guys. There are other branches in the tentacles, sorry.
Yeah, so the Classic Quest is one where we look at all sorts of classic rap albums and... Yeah, so we'll touch some old Raekwon. What did you guys think of the name of this album, The Wild?
Yo.
I thought it was pretty cool. I thought, also a little generic a little bit, though.
Yo, the album just cover, though.
Yeah, but it's kinda, like a dad joke kind of rap generic. That's right? How I felt. Like, it was like a dad joke.
Dad joke?
Yeah, like those really dorky, obvious jokes that dads make that are usually kind of cute and stuff, but this time it's like Raekwon. He's like a dad now, and he's the Wild.
Yeah,
so
it kind of
felt like a hip hop dad joke.
No, I didn't feel that. Like I saw it more in a comic book sort of like soul survivors of like
post-apocalyptic.
You're probably right.
And just like it's the wild. It's the concrete jungle. That's what I saw. Like it's you against the
concrete. Well, I got that too. That's why I felt it to be a little generic. I was like, okay, another my city, my hood type shit.
You know what I felt it was? A little dorky.
No. It gave me a wastelandish. Yeah.
I get you.
I feel everything you're saying about the cover.
That's exactly what I'm describing. That's the title. But I got that immediately. I'm a picture first and then title.
Okay, so what did you think of the title then?
Yeah, because the title.
You gave
the Wild, it complemented the picture. That's how I was able to make the connections
I feel like the Wild is a weird name for that picture. That picture's fucking
dope. Oh, I
joke,
like it.
Right?
No. I have to agree with her.
Immediately in my head, like as soon as I saw the picture and the title, to me, it meant concrete jungle.
Oh,
it was
of course.
Concrete
Instantly.
Disaster.
Instantly.
Like,
but
like,
I even got
see,
that theory I, even by like, looking
without,
at the title itself. And
without,
I was like,
without even trying to be a hater, I looked at this cover and I pictured that Will Smith movie where he's by himself at the
I am Legend, man.
Like this shit.
What about
was
Wild
like,
Wild West?
No, more I Am Legend. So like it's not like to hate on it. It's really well drawn, but like I don't know. It kind of felt kind of dorky to me.
It wakes up the comic book in me. I love
it. Yeah, it's cool. It's cool.
It is cool.
In a dorky kind of way. Like the geek in me is more excited than the hip hop head, right? So, like, I mean, I'm just saying, it's like Raekwon, I think the chef or whatever, he's fucking dope, don't get me wrong. But I kind of thought it was cute, all right? Cute is a good word for how I felt about this cover.
It's not fair cute, enough. It's bold, it's awesome, it's awesome sauce.
I thought I'm allowed to have opinions that are different.
We are also allowed to have opinions.
It's only okay if Chris has opinions that are different.
I know.
Hold it. I'm just being a hater, Damon. You guys are like have personality.
I will make your spikes curls, dude.
No, I put all sorts of products.
Okay,
it's
but
expensive.
I will look at them long enough for them to curl
Fair
up,
enough.
And you look like one of those evil villains.
So do you guys want to talk about the album?
I'm pretty down to talk about the album. Really. All right,
so let's
dive into the wild
intro.
The wild, right? A jungle with no rules.
Damon has all sorts of shit to talk about this intro. She's so excited. Why don't you tell us?
No, well, I read the thing. I was like, okay, it's an intro. It's actually an intro.
It's a nice intro.
It's something smooth to get into. It's not a song. It's not a track. It's not something.
It's very reminiscent of those 90s intros, kind of like the Biggie one, kind of like the Nas one, kind of probably like, you know, in 93 when Wu-Tang was popping off. So. Mm.
No,
I liked it. Throwback.
I'm starting to get accustomed to them.
But something like hooked me on it, and that it was the last line of it. Like, this album is dedicated to Mel Carter, and I was like, okay, of course I don't know who Mel Carter is, so I wikied him, and then actually pretty cool. Like, well, cool. I'm sorry, that's not the appropriate term. I'm sorry. He actually passed away the 25th of November 2015.
That's bad.
16.
How did he pass away?
The details were never shared. I couldn't find anything on it, unfortunately. If somebody knows, please share if it's true. But
and if it's bad, don't share.
We don't
need to know.
We don't need... Yeah, no, let's erase that.
No, it's fine. We'll keep it because it could be a good, clean story. We'll see what the internet has to say.
No, yeah, I hope it is.
But on a musical front, it builds up really ambiently, right?
Yeah, because it's Yo Gotti's manager, and they were with Lil Wayne's Wu-Tang, and especially Raekwon had a specific ties to him. They all had they all said something for him, which was saying, "Our prayers go out to the family of our beloved brother and Wu-Tang member Mel Carter. Rest in peace. # Raekwon. # super, superminute."
Man,
that's what they as a collective, the Wu-Tang clan posted that as the obituary into the obituary notes or whatever at that point. And you know what, you have our condolences as well. We feel that he was somebody very important to you, but it gave me more of an insight to the album, a little bit more of like, you know what, I learned from life. This gave me something, a more of an insight, more of a, like, you know what? No matter what comes in your way, guys, believe in yourself and you can go through it.
Very positive message.
Yeah,
very
I liked it.
Message. the intro was really cool. I'm getting accustomed because on Classic Quest, we've been having a lot of intros like that recently, and I'm getting accustomed to having these type of intros. It's very cool to kind of see how Raekwon dropped an intro like that in modern day 2017. You don't really have a lot of intros like that on these modern albums. They kind of just jump right into the trap beats and the big heavy hitters and the drums
and
shit.
To be fair, this isn't trap music. So I think
granted.
And in a lot of rap music that's not trap, there are intros like that. I don't think it's as uncommon as you might believe it is.
Fair enough. Again, if I'm wrong, let me know.
Lyrically driven, conscientious type rap. So this is like
Chris,
what us
you're wrong.
Older folk
okay.
like to call proper
it's
rap,
okay.
but I love
like
you.
Actual hip hop. You know, none of that kind
of
bullshit.
I would
bullshit.
Do
like
if
here's
I would
the
have
difference.
The chance.
Raekwon's the kind of guy that went from a really bad life to using music to tell stories to, you know, create. He treats it like the drug game. He takes it super seriously.
And that's one of the things that I like about him is that he actually takes your hand
and
like picture
when
this.
You're like making a real album, it's not just about putting a collection of songs together.
No, it's about the
and
album.
So not
it's
every
the overall message.
Not
you want to give out an overall thing.
Not every album needs an intro, but at the same time, when you're trying to tell a certain kind of story, having it there is beneficial. It's just, I don't know, if it fits, it fits. This one was really well made. It had a lot of sounds to it. It wasn't really it's more kind of talky over a beat rather than actually kind of rapping into it.
It was well thought. I have to say, like, for somebody that didn't know exactly who that person per se was, it was well thought. It was well orchestrated, and thank you.
Has,
I liked it.
A nice ambient build up as it goes through. It kind of progresses. It's about 2 minutes, and it's pretty solid. I gave it a 4 on 5.
Yeah, 4 on 5.
It's pretty. It's not great. Like, it's kind of one of those things you just have to listen to with the album. I would not, like, plus it for the sake of randoms and stuff, but it's a good start.
I'm somebody that's very dramatic. I like theater-like intros. I like, something that provides drama for my imagination. Like, I plused it. I really enjoyed it. I gave it a 4 as well.
No, I gave it a 4, too. I really liked it. It sets up the mood for the rest of the album. Gives you kind of like who he is and what he does. And for somebody who's never really listened to Raekwon, I was actually pretty excited after the first track.
So it's like we're all on the tables. Well, with
I wouldn't call that a track. That's an intro. That's not a song.
It's a good intro.
Fine. Like for an intro.
Good to know the difference. Is what I'm saying. Anyway, this is what it comes to.
Yeah. Black down, no man is safe. Your crew is cornered. Why did you think you could step over me and 2 enormous? Plus, I heard you an informant. Call Bruce, tell him roll out the plastic. I'm about to catch a body. I really like this one. So this one was the single kid that kind of...
It's the first lead single off the album. It has this video.
Yeah, came out on the first, right? 1st of February.
Yeah, I didn't check out when the dates that came out.
Yeah.
It was the first single, and it has Raekwon bopping around, and I don't know. It was a bad video.
It's really cheesy.
It's just really just Raekwon.
It's like it's all well...
A kaleidoscope view with a bunch of triangles and mirrors, and he's just...
To be honest, I watched the video.
It's like a dad video. Yo. Dad picks up a camera for the first time.
I just screwed the video at some point. I was just like, I closed it. I was like, fuck it. I'll just listen to
the song. Is nice.
Yeah, no, exactly. I closed the video and I listened to the song again. And I was just like, you know what? I could bump this in my car. Like, it's good, but it's not
dope.
Excellent.
The song's pretty, pretty dope.
I give it a 4.
I feel like the crux of this song is straight up, don't fuck with me. That's what he's trying to basically say. But
still, it was fun to listen to.
No, it's a good song. He has like a flow where it's like, I mean, listen, everything Raekwon does is aggressive as fuck and harsh, because that's his whole world, so...
Yeah, but it was like, describing, like, war, describing how, like...
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly, but
so it's what I'm saying.
I like the flow.
It's a
fun.
Great flow. It's like a lyrical onslaught. Like, it's like, every lyric is designed to punch you in the face a little bit. He's one of those.
And he does it very
rapper.
Well. He actually...
And it's very on point. It's super fucking clear. He's got that old school kind of beat here. And not every beat on the album is old school, but this one is very much a throwback to that classic 90s era that he comes from. I felt like I even wrote down, I get your project shot down while your landlord asleep. Now you in too deep, no turning back from your actions. Like, and it just goes to show you the kind of thinking he's at in this wild mentality of the city that he's in, where he's like, he's taking this general shit to, like, the next level. Like, he thinks in tactics in ways where don't fuck with him because you won't even know how he's going to come at
you. Oh, like the one I wrote, soak my bullets in cyanide so when they touch you, you know, case closed.
Right.
You know, like,
and
very,
like every single bar.
It's a power track. It's just like when you're feeling, like, upset, but you sort of want to be, like, empowered nonetheless. Like, it just, I would like
well,
this
it's one of those, it's one of those times.
I gave
times.
It a 4, though, because it's not a perfect song by any
it's
means.
It's not a perfect song,
it's
but
missing,
it does.
Like, a proper glue to really suck me in.
I feel you. I don't really have much else to say about it. I'm kind of quiet on this description. Really, I like his flow. I like the way he's presented himself. I was kind of, like I said, I've been listening to, because we're doing Classic Quest, there's been a lot. I've been getting accustomed to these albums, the old school albums, so.
We have barely touched anything from this era of rap.
No, I know we haven't touched it, but, like, I was like, okay, this is what, anyway.
This is what
it was a cool
about,
song.
Man.
It is. So, I gave it a 4 out of 5 as well. It was a really good song. It was a nice lead up to.
Nothing. Flashing his armor. Army jacket jumping in the new fist comments.
Project niggas low comments. Tolerance level is low. Don't fly through. Yup, we on it.
I just kind of want to ask. I'm kind of confused on this song if it's very literal or figurative. I kind of got this, like, feeling of, like, taking someone's pride, and that's, like, really bad, and this is what happens when you take someone's pride away.
It's a little more like a lot of people talk shit, but this is what happens when a man's put to the pressure, and it's to, like, test a man.
Okay.
This is what happens, and they really got nothing. And so that's what I took from it. It's a lot of Raekwon's the shit. Raekwon's real. And if you were to go against Raekwon, he'll prove how much of a bitch you are.
Oh, so it's another I'm better than you type track.
No, not really. Okay, because here's the difference, right? Raekwon is the real deal, where and he is now rapping in 27. He comes from it. He's been incarcerated.
Right.
He lived that life. And then you got all these guys rapping about that life, you know? But when push comes to shove, like, Raekwon would box you out. I've seen interviews with the Wu-Tang where you see Raekwon in the corner, like, get this motherfucker out the room before I knock him out, right? Like, he's not fucking around. He really is that G about it.
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, when you look at it compared to a lot of the wishy-washy rappers of today who, when push comes to shove, if a fight broke out, would run out the room or hide behind security, I think it's a fair call-out to rappers today. He's going for, like, a proper hip-hop approach.
Fair
I respect
enough.
It a lot.
I see that. Okay.
On that note, the beat's kind of lame. His rapping's on point. It's not. It's literally, like, I feel almost exactly the same about this as This Is What I Came For. I gave it another 4. I thought it was well-made, but again, it's just missing something
there
to really make
There is something missing
me...
as well. I gave it a 4 on 5 as well. I kind of felt the same way. Actually, I felt a little bit like it was similar to the previous track. I was like, oh, so it's kind of like
yeah,
B-side to that.
Well, nah, but... it's equally as good. I don't see
okay.
it as a B-side,
all
to
right.
me at least.
I didn't think it was a bad... Honestly, like, the lyrics didn't stick to me at all. I couldn't get to the concentrating for it at all, not even a little bit. So, but the flow, though, for me, it was cool. Like, as a dancer myself, like, it was just, like, I could see, like, I was feeling the flow, and I was feeling, like, the punches of the words, like, when they were coming, and it was cool. It was a good vibe for me. Like, I could go for a walk and just be happy with listening to that, like, being, I could, see, I listen to music with my moods. If my brain doesn't feel my body, guys, I can't listen to the music. So, I liked it. I gave it a 4. Because it couldn't get me over the top, like, just really, like, into it.
I enjoyed it.
It's not a meh for
I
me.
I don't know. It's not terrible. Anyway.
We could try a skit.
Like, what is this one? Bang Head Right?
Bang Head Right.
Okay, for real, we decided not to rate the skits. So some guy singing in some, like... I think it's actually CeeLo singing on this one.
No, CeeLo's on the track.
No, I think, did you guys check who sang in the skit?
It's not CeeLo. There wasn't any names.
I was just listening to the voice, and to me, it kind of sounded like CeeLo. That's all I'm trying to say.
Oh, the humor. Yes, it was CeeLo.
Because the guy singing in the skit right before the song was CeeLo, like, they were fucking around in the studio, and they recorded it. It's like, all the skits are the same, right? So if we kind of talk a little bit more about it now, we can just gloss over them later. So it's like shitty quality.
Gloss over them later?
You can literally hear the gloss. Yeah, you know, it's a real expression. Like, just...
Okay.
And then, like, you know, you got, like, you can hear the engineers and everybody in the room talking with, like, kind of microphone noises.
It was an okay skit, but moving on to a song called Marvin.
He's in all, and his father was in the ministry. God-fearing man with a mother that's so beautiful. The angels are server. What's her name? It's Alberta. This little boy quickly became a man from...
We've got CeeLo Green on this one.
Yeah, he sings on that chorus with
it's
his
nice. It's
classics.
Nice.
I like CeeLo Green.
But this song was really cool because it's that same Raekwon flow, but the beat is so nice, first of all. But this song's a story. It's like a tribute to Marvin Gaye's life. It's like it documents his ups, his downs in such a realistic way.
Like a possible problem between him and his dad, like, and just like...
That was the whole
I
way
got the whole
story.
Father-son
yeah.
dilemma.
So, like,
he
brings up
touching.
That almost all of the problems that he faced in his marriage is what led him to a lot of the things that ended up happening was this relationship. It was like almost the point of the song, and then it ends with his dad doing that awful thing that his dad did.
But it's like he's actually like I loved how he like he's telling a story. He's trying like taking you on a stroll,
yes.
And it's like it's actually painting a picture from my brain.
A perfect
like,
picture.
It's just like,
yeah, this was a fantastic,
a full animated story.
No, like,
just
like if you were to like
head.
If you had never heard the story of Marvin Gaye and you knew nothing about him as a person, Raekwon in like a 4-minute track manages to create what a documentary would take an hour to say, and I think this song is. It's
Don't
really
trust the trainer.
Man. It's a 5. It's a straight up 5 to me.
Yeah, me too. It was like.
It was really crazy. Five. Like this song will get you in the feels, though. I'm just gonna warn you. Like it's one of those subjects where, like, when you get to the end, you're like, "Damn, that Raekwon, thank you, but Tam, son, what did you think of this song?
I agree with you guys. No, I agree with everything you guys said. I've got this very strong sense of a father-son dilemma, complication, problem, issues that needed to be resolved. I am very relatable to that. Me and my father have had our ups and downs. I think everybody's had ups and downs. But I don't know. I didn't really think it was a five. Unfortunately, I was like, okay, it's just another Raekwon type flow.
There's no silly. There's no silly Christmas music in it. It's not a story about kids.
I don't know. The perfect song.
Sorry, you and your girlfriend didn't dance across the room to it.
Mock
sorry,
me
Damon.
As you
these
will.
Are classic
Did you try to have sex
Mock
at the same
as
time
you
as
will.
This?
These, okay,
Mock me
so just some context. We were reviewing another album, and somehow Chris rated this obscure song a perfect five while dissing it, and then proceeded to give the next song a four while calling it perfect. So that's why sometimes we need to poke some
to
fun
understand.
At Chris. And Chris said, if you want him to get his knowledge on, leave it in the comments below, and he will. Hashtag Chris.
That.
Awesome.
So anyway, I thought, okay, it's cool. You don't have to think it's a perfect song. You can see
Chris.
Why. To me, it was amazing. But Damon, go.
Can't you see, Chris?
In all green, New Balance sneaker, white Wranglers on the scene. We was youngsters, 80s babies getting in shit. Stolen cars, felt for monkey bars, flipping and shit.
So at this point, I started noticing how awful the annotations were at genius.com. And how it was just a question mark.
Oh, yeah.
There was just shit missing and stuff. Like, yep. The whole intro to this song wasn't there. The whole intro wasn't there. I was so annoyed. So I signed up. Now I'm going to be an annotating genius lyric editing
yes.
fucker. So
oh,
if you
look.
See HSR514 up on that site, it's
Please
me.
Please like
That's
the
all
thing.
I'm trying to say. But so I wrote out the intro to this song because it wasn't there. I started correcting shit along the way. And I was very disappointed with the quality of whoever transcribed the lyrics on my site. And I think that...
But still,
look,
thank
I,
you
I didn't,
for putting
I didn't
it
have
there.
Enough time. But
you
if
know,
I could have, man, I would have torn over the whole fucking thing and I would have fixed it. It was really bothering me.
But it's better than nothing. Like, honestly, like, sometimes they're not there. Like, thank you for those who took the time
so,
to initially put it
in
there.
In the future,
anyways.
If I'm not rushing last minute to review an album, I will put more effort into fixing shit. But still, this song was nice. I liked it a bit.
I got a little confused. Really...
So, this song is just wisdom, right? It's like it's the sum of it is live smarter. I wrote down some shit I really thought was cool. Now it's all about good living, raising my children. I done seen the flames escape from the hailstorms. Credentials of a high chief, blowing on that potent broccoli. My whole earth got a chance to see a black man run the White House.
Yeah.
So what he's saying, like, you know, I've taken over. I've been able to do all of these games. I've been able to go from living in that other life to living in this life,
and
now everything's
only,
okay.
He doesn't only glorify himself. He talks
exactly.
about how it was when they were kids, like how they were fucking around and just,
yeah.
like, you know,
right.
stealing shit and just, like, looking at the gangs and, like, oh, I want to be like them and just pretending. And now he has a family and he's doing the responsible thing. He shows through this a message, like, he believes in
yeah,
redemption.
Be
like, no matter what, like, you can come back from anything. Like, he's coming back from it, right?
I found the beat a little slow and jazzy. It was okay. It just wasn't my kind of beat. So I gave it a 4/5
See,
for that reason.
Me, like, I loved the jazzy part, but it was still missing, like, I feel the dragginess of it. Like,
right.
It's
just
like...
not full.
But I'd be down to go out for a walk again with that. Like, I'd be chill with that. So I gave it a 4 as well.
Oh, well, unfortunately, I kind of gave it a 3.
You know
it's
what?
Not a bad song.
I can understand where you're coming from on this one. This is a reasonable grade.
Mm. All right. I don't know. I didn't really feel much to it. I was like, okay, it's not a bad song. It's not really, I guess, my niche or my typical sound. So I was like, nah, leave it at a 3. Check it out. But we can move
on. It's solid, though. I just want to say it's still good, but it's nothing like being on my corner with Lil Wayne.
Kill, for real. Picture me stomping you out up on a flying train. Grip nights on. Hollow through your hollow brain. I suffocate cats. I rape tracks. All of this.
Third single on the album, and apparently I had a lyric video I didn't watch because I don't really watch lyric videos.
That's okay. I watched the lyrical video. It's just it's pretty cool. They're just coming at
you.
Are they
in it? Are they like actually in it?
No,
oh,
it's
okay.
just the lyrical video.
No, sometimes, it's just the words. They
sometimes
pop up.
Like I know Yellow Wolf once did a lyrical video where he was in it, and okay, it was like green screen, so it was like a half music video. But So anyway, this beat is hype. This beat is so dirty, hype,
yep.
beautiful,
yep.
gorgeous. This is a sexy. If this beat was a girl, it's got a bedonkadonk. Is all I'm trying to say right here.
Yep.
Woof! It was very fun. I really liked Raekwon. It was hype.
I love that part.
I can't believe I'm about to say this. But I really like Tunchi enough to call him Tunchi. Like, it was fucking nice. Like, he wasn't on lean. He was coherent. He had talent. Okay, maybe his bars were Wayne bars, all right? Fine, it's Wayne
for
bars.
For those who doesn't know, Lil Wayne, let's just say it, because I didn't know what Tunchi was. I just made the thing.
The real Tunchi is his little nickname. He ends the verse calling himself Tunchi.
Oh, that's what it was.
Yeah.
I just assume most people know that. I apologize to those of you watching who don't. But yeah, so Wayne came at it with, like, actual talent. Look, I don't know if what he rapped about was good, but I heard tricks in his little bars. It was not boring. His flow was non-static. This is the best Wayne verse I think I've heard in, I don't remember the last time I heard
really
a Wayne
well.
Verse.
They both did really fucking well.
This
was really
a surprising banger of bangers.
Like, this is this great.
Album.
This is a really fucking
All it
fucking
needed
great
was,
song.
Like, some fucking hook with a, like, some hook to it, you know?
Yeah, that's exactly how I felt about it. Because I love Raekwon at the beginning. I absolutely loved it. I was like, oh, this beat, this just follows in. I love it. It's just, and then Lil Wayne came in, and I wasn't expecting that. Like, it took me a bit to, like, get used to it. And I didn't really associate the lyrics. But like you said, like, the punches were cool. Like, it was just like okay, like, where did he actually think? Where'd you fart that from? Like,
it wasn't
how?
Like, hammer.
No, it was cool. it was just good. But to me, it took me too much time to get used to it. Like, and then I listened to it a second time because I wanted to sort of like wash myself from Lil Wayne and then get back to the top. But then Lil Wayne's part sort of like clicked to me. Like, it's just like, oh, okay, it's actually cool. It's cool to listen to.
This is okay. So Lil Wayne's full of shit. I don't believe him at all. But otherwise, it's a proper gangster track. I don't know, man. This song's a 5 for me. This is my kind of gangster rap. This is like when I want a hard-hitting track. This is like when you want to listen to Migos. This is my version of what the... This is my... What I want. And this
and
is...
You
want
what?
That crap,
I really like this song. It didn't get a perfect. But I like this song.
Right, because it didn't have no raindrops and drop tops in
it. No, it did not.
Oh, I give it a 4. There's just a missing. It was a little bit draggy for me, it gave me a 4.
No, this, like, I haven't plussed it yet on Spotify. Watch, I'm about to do it right now. It was a mistake. Plussed. Wow, I can't believe I forgot to do that earlier. It's that good. Okay, so the next thing's another skit. This time it's a fuck you up something. Oh,
fuck you up card.
Right, my bad. So, right, this one is my favorite skit. It was more tolerable than the other ones.
They were like on helium or something.
And
like,
yeah, it was okay. Anyway, I didn't really care about the skit. Do you care about the skit?
No.
Okay. So moving on.
Eminem.
Not Eminem, folks. That's
and
like Nancy.
Majestic, marvelous, mind over matter more. My murder is militant, mutilate millions. Monsters with the most masculine muscle, maxing in a major way, munching, making more moves.
First of all, alliteration is the sexiest thing you can do lyrically. In fact, in the
oh, cool, like
and this
poems,
whole
like...
fucking song is alliteration almost the whole way through.
Oh,
like, here's an example.
I liked it, though.
Allow me to quote from the music instead of my own bullshit. Majestic, marvelous, mind over matter, more my murderous, militant, mutilate millions, monsters with the most masculine muscle, maxing in a major way, munching, making more moves, maintaining. Listen, the dudes from Nova Scotia, they saw, that's Canada, that's my country, motherfuckers.
Yeah, I was going to ask, who the hell is he?
He's from Nova Scotia, Maritimes.
Woo, love this.
And they were both hype, they were both high energy. Like, this is like Raekwon on steroids compared to some of the other shit. The alliteration brought it to the next level. The beat is fucking amazing. I gave this shit another 5. It was such a great song. Like, at this point, I was flying on the album. After that Wayne song, after this song, I was like, wow. Wow, this is some cool shit is where I'm going with it.
You know what? Like, I was watching it and I was trying to, like, honestly, pure love it. Raekwon, love it as well. I have no problem with either.
Right.
They were, like, so, like, synchronized. It was cool. It was just, like, one on top of the other.
Yeah.
I did have one eensy little poop about it, which was that I couldn't tell them apart. At some point, I just got lost in the loop.
You know,
I got confused into it at some point.
I get where you're coming from, but I'm okay with that because it was so great sounding still.
It was cool, but I really wanted to get pure out of it. I wanted to, like, delete, like, I wanted to concentrate on pure a little and,
like,
just get a little bit more out of him. Just,
well, that's why you go after this and you go to Pure's Spotify.
I know, but I just, exactly, but for me, I just couldn't concentrate enough to, like, make it out, so.
It's okay.
You know what? Like, I want
to
get,
five
I want to look,
five.
I want
to
look
me.
More into you, dude.
You got
but,
me
like,
in my heart, both of you. Chris?
I got a 4.
Okay, guys, so I just want to talk about it. So I was walking up the street
while Holden. Fuck. Come on, Chris.
Damn, I'm going to really, defend you. I really, really like the...
It's like when you're playing video games and you teabag the fucker so they suck better.
Right?
And that's what I just did to Chris.
Okay, so I...
Woo! Shut up, Holden.
Okay. Go on, Chris. Feel better. You're confident. Dude, you're a strong, independent woman that don't need no man.
Fucking asshole.
Okay. All right. So,
oh, God.
Regarding this M and N song, I really liked how they went back and forth, like Damon said. I really liked the way they fucking had the wordplay, and they just played on, again, the same letter and everything. It was really, really cool. I didn't give it a perfect score only because I get it. It's super cool to do it, but at a certain point, I need a little break. Personally, for me, I want to hear something else a little bit.
I can listen to alliteration all day long.
And that's totally fine. So I gave it a 4.
Alphabet slaughter on repeat.
See, with that, I see poems. I see stories. And with that, I need dramatization. So I need that little break, melodic. He's right. Like, that's exactly what was missing. I couldn't put my finger on it.
It was short, guys. Like, keep in mind, this song was only 2 minutes and 20 seconds.
It's awesome that they're so short. I love it.
Some of them are long.
It gives you a little... Yeah. But it's still, since the majority of them aren't too long, it gives you like a cool like refresh to the
mix. That's kind of why I feel like it didn't need all that melodic stuff, because it didn't drag on. It got to the right end and it just kind of like ended.
But I wanted it to.
That's okay. Everyone else is entitled to their opinions and blah, blah, blah.
Except for me.
Anyway, you're entitled to them.
Guys, it's visiting hours.
Really?
Yeah. Close, I'm not alone. Smoking that black cabbage, making my enemies poop be gone. So the facts is, money make niggas throw rocks at the throne. I think it's swollen in action. Like songs that are laced with knowledge and wisdom. And this verse about that chick, what's her name?
Andrea Day.
Man, she starts off with so much power and it creates such a tone setter. Yep. Here's the melody that you guys were just asking for. See, all you had to do is wait those 2 minutes and 20 seconds
for
it.
Yes, we did. That's all we had to do.
Hold on, you know what? That's exactly how I felt when I was listening to it. I was like, that's exactly what was missing.
And then the whole song is so deep, though, right?
Like, ooh, yes, it is.
He basically drills home that as much as you don't realize it, 25 to life is basically death. And he drives home the whole perspective of doing what you have to do with this mindset. But then the reality of the situation kicks in, and it's like, it's not fucking around. And all of his boys, he went to jail, he reflects on it, and he laments on all of this shit and how people were just so callous with it. And it's so deep, and the music is so beautiful.
Everything about it is beautiful.
I give this a 5 because, honestly, like, I don't even know how to really rate this. It was emotional. It was charged. It was a theatrical experience the whole way through.
It kind of like it creates a cinematic in your own head because it gives you this.
That's exactly what he does.
Paint a perfect picture on this canvas.
He has a very good way with the once upon a time esque of the
imagery of the words.
Like I feel like this is like if you were really gonna show a song to somebody to show the depth of what this guy can do, I would probably pick this one off this
album. I gave it a 5. I gave it a 5.
Yeah, I gave it a 5. Like the contrast between her melody, the drama behind the sound, and what he was saying was just like perfectly interlaced. Like it was just like mind blowing for me. It took me into another world.
So, yeah, I think that it's fucking weird how the more we like the song, the harder it is to really say anything good about it. It's just like, yeah, it's fucking great. Yeah,
sorry, I love it. It's just like,
So you know what I didn't like as much?
The band called out skit.
Yeah, the next skit. So there was another skit. Like, here's the good part about this one. It's 34 seconds, so half the length of the other skits. Okay. Let's talk about...
No. Oh.
What, the next song?
Never mind.
Is that what you don't want to talk about? The rain? Play is wicked as wild, fly with his wild power. Got me flying over the globe. Nigga, where you be at? Not where I be. Rich, wealthy, and ruthless in Morocco. Blowing cohibos. Striving for... Let's talk about The Rain. This sounds like the classic throwback. Cuban Lynx is one of the old Raekwon albums from back in the day. Hell, maybe we'll even talk about it just for you, Chris, because I know how much you love this song. I like the hook a lot because the hook sells the idea that if you take the mentality of the thug life in the streets and the whole gangsterisms and you apply it to writing words,
I get that, but it just seems so repetitive. Granted, it's a good song. It's a good song. It's not a bad.
This is what it is, right? It's a throwback to that kind. But everything in that era kind of sounded like that, right? This was like. A lot of what, I think even, what was it, Rick Ross kind of sounded like this, Fat Joe kind of sounded like this, a lot of these guys.
That's the thing, I was saying, I was speaking earlier today, I was listening earlier today.
No, I was like sitting on a chair and just like.
It's not bad, I don't really like this one as much as others, but I still thought it was a four. Like, he's still a king in this world, man, like.
I get it, but I've heard him say he's the king in like three other fucking songs.
He
never
said he was the king, really, this was his reign, he was describing what he's accomplished, why he's the shit, how his wisdom has come from, how he uses his drug dealing knowledge to make money off of music. I respect it. It's a four.
I gave it a three.
I also found it extremely repetitive, and not that it's just like, I gave it a three too. Like, I can't ignore the talent of like the lyrical, like you said, like it was cool.
Right, he's got bars.
It's just for me as a musical. Like, I'm a music like flow type of person, so it didn't hit anything.
Don't make him wear his crown of thorns. Better than Levi's, laid there, two chains on. Where's the throne? I was slick, like poetress who know his shit, cold as shit. Thugs that stay loaded and blow. I feel like at this point, it's a blender effect for me. Yep. This sounded exact. So blender effect, for those who don't know yet, is when the songs start kind of sounding the same and you can't tell them apart anymore. Subject matters, and come on, like, it's the same premise, the same idea.
It makes me go crazy because I can't tell them apart. It's like, oh, wait, hold on. Did I just listen to this? Did I not?
Did the last song end? Did the new one begin?
Right? You're just kind of like, what the fuck? Shit.
Like, for real. It's from a music front. They're really similar. The flows are really similar.
You know what? At least they didn't do a slash song.
You're right.
You know?
Thank you, Raekwon.
At least they didn't do a slash song.
Thank you so much.
But at least if he made a slash song, he could have taken out
one.
What?
No, 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 no.
Shut up.
Shut up.
At least
shut up.
Shut up. Sorry.
Okay, Chris. Tell us about why a slash song would have saved it.
At least if he did a slash song, he could have removed this track and actually turned it into something different.
No. With how slash song seems to work is he would have taken these two songs as they were. And put a slash between them.
No.
That's slash songs.
Like everyone.
I think he could have changed it fine, but this song got a three.
Now you're making assumptions. You said a what? A three?
This song got a three.
Yeah, I got a three for me, man. You know what? You gotta follow the purple brick road. I gave y'all style, taught you how to be fly. Go ahead and grace the sky. Gave you wings to soar like you ought to. Forever may not exist in the flesh, but my music will all praises due to the most.
So this song has G-Eazy on it.
Yeah.
And it has that girl that's on all the G-Eazy songs when there's no real feature put there.
If anybody knows who that girl is, please comment below and let us know what's going on.
Albeit, I didn't spend more than 4 minutes. I didn't spend more than a minute looking. In that minute, I did not find out who she was, so I gave up and I said it's the G-Eazy girl, because I swear I've heard her on G-Eazy shit before.
I didn't know who G-Eazy was.
He's that white guy who just appeared wearing nice clothing and raps a bunch of stuff.
Obviously, I saw
it. He basically makes music for the girls who want to go to Soho Lofts and party, and he makes music just, I guess, like exactly for the type of girl that wants to sleep with him. And his career is solid. He's not bad, and that's what he is. What he heard on this song is a lot of what he is, but this is a harder side of G-Eazy.
No, he's got better songs. I didn't really like his verse. I like his flow, his presentation, the way he did it, but I don't like what he says. I was like, you kind of just were like, humming and such and such, look at
me. He's basically saying, the industry is going to take me seriously this year, because as you can see, I'm with Raekwon. As you can tell, my shit's getting better. Mm. And Raekwon is like, you know, life is good. We done all blah, blah, blah. And he's sitting there in a beautiful house and whatnot. Again, it's kind of from a lyrical point of view, a lot of the same thing. The flow's nice. That beat is such a G-Eazy beat. Like,
Yes, it is.
It's completely what you would expect. So it's kind of like, you hear the chorus and you're waiting for G-Eazy to start rapping about getting a girl drunk and taking her home. And then, nope, Raekwon shows up. And it's not bad. It's not at all. It was cool, actually.
Yep.
And then G-Eazy does show up but doesn't rap about taking a girl home, which is weird. And I don't know. I like this song a lot.
You know what? He gave me a cool Macklemore effect to me. Like, he gave
they
me
do
like
sound
just
so
a
similar.
Then he looks sort of like him a little bit, just a tiny, like, anyways. But honestly, this song, such amazing. It took me to fucking La La Land. I loved it. It was just, like, so just, like, tiptoey. I didn't really, honestly, like, I tried to pay attention to the lyrics, but I was so, like, I lined up, okay, I sort of lined up the YouTube video with my Spotify playing in the surround system to give me, like, a doubling. Dude, I managed to, like, sync it up perfectly.
And
at the same time, I was able to follow in the lyrics and read at the same time. So I was just, like,
multitask for the win.
Yeah. All I gotta say is it's a 4. Oh. It's not a perfect
gave it a 5.
No, because
I loved it. I loved it. G-Eazy
did not really give me what I was hoping for out of him. Because I've come
You said it. He made it for ladies.
Look, I've become a G-Eazy fan. I'm putting it out there.
No,
Vengeance on My Mind, sick track. Tumblr Girl, sick track. And you can go on. Like, he's not bad at what he does. But this is not a great example. Raekwon felt a little bit like he was a little uncomfortable on the beat, but otherwise it was pretty solid. So it was a 4. It was almost perfect.
No, this song is absolutely a 4.
But you're allowed to think it's a 5, right? You are entitled to your
plan was foreign. Grew up on stick ups, whole click rock. Now we ain't starving. Yes, pulling out big notes.
Yes, jumping in the big S. I'm fresh. All about success. Let's flex. I honestly thought it was Jeezy at first. It's such a fucking hype beat, man. It's so strong. His flow is it's fucking the best song. Like,
it's
really?
It's fucking dope. I don't know why I had to wait till the last song to hear it.
Well, it's a good placement on the fucking album, isn't it?
If you don't consider it, hold on.
On other albums, if we don't put the banging on the last song, Chris will be like, you know, we should have taken that song and moved it down to
the
end.
I just, like, rearranged fucking tracks all over the goddamn place.
So all I'm saying is this was a real power track, as Damon was saying. It's fucking strong as fuck. It's just bars in a way that's not boring.
It's not fucking boring.
It doesn't actually sound like the rest of the album. It's a fucking perfect 5 for me. It is an excellent last song on this album. This is some grimy ass, like, proper trap like shit.
You know what, I was listening to it again right now and it did give me that that feel of a 5. However, I looked down and there was a 4. Okay, I love it. Like I said, it's a power track. It's good for dancing. However, I really tried really hard, and this is why it got a 4. I couldn't get what this song was about. I couldn't understand it. I was like, oh, these are cool punches, but why? Why? I couldn't understand it at all. It's just to hear him. It was cool to have the bars, yeah, but I couldn't understand what it was.
It's the same as a lot of the rest of the album. He's the greatest he's the realest. Now, Raekwon has never once on this album wanna make it up, but, like, he's great. He's like, look, I am using my intelligence and my business tactics and my prowess to create a better life for myself. I'm giving you my wisdom. Do you hear me? And he's doing it so well because he really is a hype rapper with it. I don't know, man. 5. I can't even think
straight
of
5.
It.
Straight 5.
I gave it a 4. I'm sorry. I'm going to stay true to the first impression, but I really wish I put a 5, but I gave it a 4.
Like, if you're into that hard-hitting Grammy shit, this is it. This is the track for you.
It was good. It was awesome, but I couldn't.
So then there was this bang outro, and this is just a longer
version.
Let's say it's the longest.
I actually like this outro better than any other skit.
It was more tolerable than the other ones, but I was kind of hoping a little more for anything. Anyway, fuck that shit. It's over. The album's done. So we decided for the gradings to cut the skits. So we rated it on 12. We kept the intro in.
Oh, yeah, true.
Because it's dope. Mm-hmm. So, weirdly enough, this got a 4.33, man. I gave this a high rating. I respect a lot what this album brought to the table.
You got a 4.33?
Yeah.
I got a 4.2.
I got a 4.08.
Well, either way, according to Classic Quest standards, everybody here just caught the shit at Classic Live.
It's really amazing,
man. I'm truly impressed. Like, this guy's a real legend. He's not one of those fake dudes. And even, like, if he did the same thing on every song, unlike other people, he managed to make it fucking real as fuck, you know?
It gives me a good first impression for the introduction to who he is. Like, I'm actually pretty cool.
Hold on a second. Do you guys realize what we might be able to review next week?
What?
Do you know what's coming out on Friday?
Oh, you're a cunt. No.
Kendrick Lamar.
No!
Kendrick Lamar.
Oh, my!
Oh, my gosh. Kendrick Lamar is dropping April 7th. That means Headspace 22. We're covering Kendrick Lamar. And this week on Classic Quest, we're covering what, Chris?
Kendrick Lamar's Good Child, Bad City.
So we got some fun shit coming on like that.
If
you want to pay attention to us and holla at us and stuff, you can tweet us and Twitch at her. because she twitches. And then whatever Chris wants you to do for him, like diddle him.
Dude, a tweet.
In the
says.
Show more, all of the links are there. The contact information of your choice, the conversations, the album link for Spotify is there. And we like you. My headspace is so full. I feel like I'm going to explode at some point soon. I don't know if anyone wants to say goodbye.
Bye. Anyone.
Bye, Chris. You're fired.
Bye.
Is he really fired?
No.
Goodbye.
I was just pretending to be Donald Trump from The Apprentice.
Isn't that like a show?
Okay, guys, we see you next Monday.